Hey, I'd like to welcome you to another episode of the Mission Matters Business Podcast, your source for all things business. My name is Adam Torres. You can follow me on Instagram at AskAdamTorres. Keep up with my book releases, book tour schedule, signings, all that other good stuff. Always love to connect with you there. And as always, if you'd like to apply to become a co-author of one of my upcoming books, just head on over to the website, missionmatters.com, and click on Become an Author to Apply. All right, so today I have Joe Pyritz on the line, and he's a communication specialist over at the University of Arizona Health Sciences. Joe, welcome to the show.
Well, thank you very much, Adam. I'm really looking forward to this. It's great to be here.
So, Joe, excited to get into today's topic. So we're going to talk about the government communications landscape, which you have quite a background on, and we're going to get into that some of that too. But before we do, tell us a little bit more about what you're doing over at the University of Arizona, please.
Yes, Adam. I work in the Health Sciences Department of the University of Arizona in the All of Us Research Program. The All of Us Research Program is being sponsored by the National Institutes of Health, or NIH. And they're seeking to get 1 million people to donate their DNA so that we can take a look and perform precision medicine on people in the United States. And it's quite a job to do, trying to get 1 million people across the United States to donate blood, basically, so that we could take a look at their DNA and their genomics and see how best that precision medicine can help them.
Man, that is quite an undertaking, and to say that's a big project is an understatement. That's huge. That's a lot of work. I do want to switch it up a bit, though. I do want to get a little bit further into today's topic. So let's get into the government communications landscape and kind of where we're at, what we can do, what we can't do. Maybe a good way to start this off is just give us a little bit of your background and what you've done in government communications, please.
Okay, first of all, I started off as a typical journalist doing broadcast journalism at a local station in Tucson as a news and sports anchor. And then I applied for a position at a local government agency and became their public information officer. So there I spent 20 years doing that. And I started out at the time when you would get out a press release by sending out a fax. And now we look at today's landscape, and I mean, we have social media, you have all sorts of avenues where you can reach the public. And I honestly think at this time that through government, you should be better able to handle the communication challenges today than what we had in the past.
So let's go further down that line. So where are we at today? Like, where do you think some of the opportunity areas are? I mean, this is a big topic. There's only so much, obviously, we can cover in a 10 to 15 minute podcast episode, but I do want to get covered what we can. So where are we at today?
Well, right now, I think a lot of governments, they basically focus in on social media. And government communications is more than just reaching out with social media, because not everybody has social media. The county that I worked at, half of it was very technology friendly. Another half wasn't. So the charge for me was figuring out how to reach both areas, because there are certain areas in the mountains community that didn't have internet. All they would have was their cell phones, and they would get their data streamed by the cell phone. But I think, government communications is more press releases. You use the social media. I'm not going to toss away the social media. That's an important part. But a lot of it is press releases to explain your point and your information more clearly than you can in a 175-character tweet. And it's also personal meetings, getting out there and talking to people. Because I can tell you, you would think you understood a topic. You go out and talk to the people. You got talk to the people who took the time to meet with you. And you would get a different view of what was going on.
What do you think of some of the, I mean, there's definitely people in government listening to this right now, and people that are working for nonprofits and just, different, let's just say, interest groups along the line are listening to this. What do you think is some of the low-hanging fruit? Like, what are some of the things that people should be thinking about today, whether they're at the governmental capacity or other NGOs or otherwise?
Yeah, I have a friend of mine, Norm Karkos, out in Maine, and he told me, basically, he says, keep it consistent. Keep it simple, stupid, that KISS reference. It's consistent messaging all the way through. And whether it is through the social media, that is a very low-hanging fruit. A lot of social media is free. You can use it. But at the same time, is you have to expand your reach. And again, press releases, you can send them out through email, through an email subscriber list. Those things are free. And you can get that. I use Constant Contact, which wasn't free at the county. But we had over 20,000 subscribers, and that's an easy way to get out your message there. And again, another free way to do it is get personal meetings at public locations, get out there, meet the people. I mean, those are low-hanging things. You can go a lot of cities, a lot of in bigger cities, a lot of people will depend upon the media to cover them. And right now, the media is being shut down so much because a lot of companies are taking over these TV stations and the radio stations, and they're doing a lot of national coverage. A lot of local coverage is being cut out right now.
Yeah, I tell people this all the time. I love that you bring that up. And then the easiest example is when Radio 1 and Clear Channel basically bought all the radio stations. And now you turn on any radio station and you're going to hear the same playlist, right, of songs. Like, that's just – I shouldn't say any, but let's just say the majority. Why? Because there's two big conglomerates that own it all. So your local artist that maybe you would normally hit, that the DJ had the ability to play or promote or to kind of add – or infuse their style to, you don't get that. The same thing I think happens and is relatable here is that as these conglomerates continue to, let's just say, eat up those smaller things, they're buying data, they're buying lists, they're buying access to local communities, but they're also, I don't want to say that we're pushing their agenda because not everybody is. There's still real journalism being done. It's just harder and harder to find it. Like, so you combine those things and it's just a recipe for more homogeny, like less opinions, less informed views, and ultimately a less informed public.
Exactly.
That's what we do here. Like, we consider ourselves a local group, and we continue to do that, and we continue to bring stories and local business owners, entrepreneurs, executives, so that people have, you know, insight as to what's going on from their end. We intentionally don't do a lot of the national stuff because it, to us, it's like it's just more of the same headlines, more of the same this, more of the same that, and quite frankly, I don't want to cover it, just to be honest, but I don't think it makes for interesting content to duplicate what's already being done and to kind of add that slant to it. I think we try to be that voice of the people is really our goal of the business community. So Joe, that being said, if somebody is listening to this and they want to kind of follow up and to learn more about your work and what you're doing going forward, I mean, what's the best way for them to do that and to get involved?
If people really want to get in touch with me about, you know, getting some ideas on how government can communicate a little bit better and how they can push back in a way, they can contact me on LinkedIn at Joe Pyritz, and that's spelled J-O-E, the common spelling. Last name is P-Y-R-I-T-Z, or they can email me at joepyritz, all one word, at comcast.net.
Fantastic. Well, Joe, really appreciate you coming on the show today and sharing more about your background and all the great work you're doing, and also really just bringing light to today's topic and really helping people understand, you know, the government communications landscape overall, where we're at, and maybe some things to help improve going forward. So great stuff there. And to the audience, as always, thank you for tuning in. Hope you got a lot of value out of this. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to the podcast. Leave me a review on the Apple iTunes Store. And if you're watching this on our YouTube channel, Mission Matters Business, definitely give us a subscribe there. But also leave us some comments in the video. Love to know what kind of projects and things that you're working on. And Joe, thanks again for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me, Adam. I appreciate it.